Okay, on the right we have Google Tasks. On the left we have Microsoft To Do. We're going to take both of them, put the exact same task in them, and then see how they act differently. So on the left-hand side, this is a browser with the To Do application pulled up. And as you can see in the lower left-hand corner, it's integrated with Outlook. So you would check your mail and your calendar from here. And then the last option would bring you to a To Do. And on the right-hand side, you can see that Task is integrated with Gmail. So the way that you access Task, if I close this, has to be full screen, is that there's this toolbar on the right with your calendar, keep, and tasks. So I'm going to click on that. I'm going to bring it back to the right so you can see both. And actually for To Do on the left, I'm going to bring up the app. So I've installed this app on Windows 10, and I'm going to use this to show it to you just because it shows it a little bit easier. It has the left-hand pane on here. You don't have to expand it, but it's going to be the same functionality whether it's here on the desktop or on your mobile device. We're just going to record some tasks in them, and I'm going to show you how they are going to work differently. So the first thing that I want to do is I want to go grocery shopping. I'm going to add it to my to-do. So I just typed it in on the first line. I click add. And what happens here is a couple different things. One is it just added it to my task. There's a default list down here that was created, and it's grocery shopping. The second thing to notice that Microsoft To Do has done is it's added it to what it's called My Day. And let's go on the left-hand side and go to My Day. We're going to click on this. And My Day is kind of the unique feature of To Do. And this is what you're supposed to create every day for just what you want to do that day. So we're actually going to do grocery shopping tomorrow. So what I will do first is I'll take it out of My Day. Let's just right click on it and choose remove from my day. So let's go over and add the same task to Google Task. And I'm going to left click and just add grocery shopping. I'm going to hit enter. So what's happened here is it's added the task, and then it adds a new blank line below it, just waiting for me to add another one. So we said we're going to do this tomorrow. In Google Task, I'm going to click on the pencil, and then I'm going to add a particular date to it. I'm going to make it tomorrow. And we'll go back. And what that has done, that's added a little icon to tomorrow. And if I look at my Google Calendar in the same account, if you make sure that your calendar with your task is turned on, so I'm going to put a check mark there, you'll see this on your calendar. This is going to pop up on the day that you tell it to, and if you click in it, it will have some of the details. But let's go back to task. The calendar is just one way to view it, but we're going to be working with them through task. And let's go over to Microsoft To Do. It's put it down in task. Let's left click on it to open it up. We get this little panel, and we're going to add a due date to this to be tomorrow. And what this has done is you can see that it's assigned to tomorrow. And if you go to planned, this will be organizing things for you by date. And that was done automatically when I moved it to tomorrow. The next thing that we want to do to these tasks is that we want to have little subtasks. So when we go grocery shopping, we're going to, in To Do, we're going to add steps. And we're going to add bananas. Hit your enter key. And then we're going to add kiwis. Let's close that window. And you can see in the grocery shopping, 0 of 2 are done. If I left click on it again, it'll bring up the steps. Over in Google Task, if we click on grocery shopping, we can add what they are calling subtasks. It's the same thing, right? Bananas, and we're going to add kiwis. So the task and the subtask are pretty similar between To Do and tasks, except that you see the subtask in Google Tasks, which is a pretty significant difference. And now we're going to add another task that we want to do today. So we're going to do it in To Do first. We're going to go up to the My Day. We're going to clean the house. So just left click to add. And since you started in My Day, it's going to add it to My Day. So as we go down the task and you look at these two things, the grocery shopping is assigned tomorrow. But to clean the house, you put it in My Day, which is supposed to be everything that you want to do this day, but you didn't technically assign it to today. You want to do that, you can just add a due date and make it today. But that does put it in the planned. So if you left click on planned, you'll see today and tomorrow. So it depends on how you want to manage things in To Do. you want to just use my day, you don't have to assign it also to today because that can be a little bit redundant. But if you go over to Google Task, we're going to add a task, clean the house. And it's somewhat similar. So let's click out of this task. It puts it on top because it's not tomorrow. So it's assuming it's today. But you can also assign it to today. When you back out, these are in chronological order and it's labeled today and tomorrow. So with doing it on today is going to bring it to your calendar. So let's look at today. Clean the house is on there. If I go back in to clean the house and I take it off of today and I go back into the calendar, it's gone from today. So keep that in mind as you're using Google Task, is that if you don't give it a day, if you're relying on your calendar, you're not going to see it. If we want to categorize tasks in certain lists, it's rather apparent how to do it in Microsoft To Do. So we'll come over here and we'll make a new list and we're going to say school. And our task is going to be study for a test. And we're going to put that off as long as possible. So we're going to left click in it and we're going to make it next week. I'm going to close that. So let's do the same thing in Google Task. So if you want another list, right now I only have a list that's called My Task. So you'd have to go down here to create new list and we'll say school. Click on done. And now when you're looking at school, this is behaving differently than Microsoft To Do, right? So Microsoft To Do, I see I'm in the school task, but I see the numbers of the other ones here as well. So I feel like there's other things to do. In Google Task, if you're looking at school, everything else goes away. So if you want to study for a test, and let's put that one off as well. Let's move it to the 28th and back up. You see that it's on your school list, but if you go back to your main list, you don't see it there. So keep that in mind as you're using Google Task. In Microsoft To Do, if you go, let's say, to the plan, you still see that you have one plan in your school list. And it also comes up when you click on plan, you'll see the study for test is on here. Now it's not in my day if we go there, because this is just supposed to be what you're going to do today. But it is in planned. Now, if we start it, it would come up in important as well. So let's do that. Let's go study for a test. I really need to do this. So we'll start it. We'll come back and it comes to important also. I don't know that I'd be using my day and important in plan, but it's there if it works for you. The important option is not in Google Tasks and you're not going to see your other lists unless you click on them. However, let's look at that school list, and I did plan it on January 28th, so you are going to see it on your calendar. But I'm using Microsoft To Do's app on the left, and the calendar can't be seen here at all. If I go back to the web app and I click on My Day, I can see it in planned, just like I could in the application that's running locally on my computer. But if I go to the calendar, let's look at January 27th. This is loading up Outlook. It does not flow through to the calendar. So that's a big difference in Microsoft To Do compared to Google Task. Maybe you don't want them on your calendar, but if you do, they're not on there. So another important difference between Microsoft To Do and Google Tasks is that you can share a list. You can't share particular tasks. That option goes away at this level. But this entire list, the school, can share it with someone if you left click on the icon and you send them a link to it. No such feature in Google Tasks. So let's go back to My Task and we'll go back to Task on the left. And one last thing to note is that Task functions like its own list. So if you put something in school, it's not going to be in Tasks and vice versa. Now if you put something in school and you can also add it to My Day, and you can add it to important and planned. It'll come in those, but just task is its own separate list. You can't add it to both. So after I recorded this video, but before I released it, Microsoft added the ability to attach files to each to-do. So that's another thing that to-do can do that Google Task cannot. You can also just see an overview of Microsoft To Do in this video I'm showing on the screen. Or if you want to compare Microsoft To-Do to a little bit of a heavier Google option, which is Google Keep. I also did that. I find that one interesting personally because I like Google Keep better. It has more functionality than Google Tasks. If you like this and you want to subscribe to my channel, and click that little bell icon after you subscribe and you'll get a notification as the new ones come out. Thanks for watching.